Thank you for joining us today. Before we start our panel, I actually have an announcement. Many of you probably were at the opening ceremony last night where we announced the two Award of Excellence recipients. And after that, we were approached by Mr. Sridhar Lal Manandar himself, who is here with us again. I'd just like to reintroduce you. But Mr. Manandar and his family came to us to say that they'd like to make this announcement here that you know, they're really happy about this award and the festival, and so they've actually been inspired to set up a foundation. So the details of that hasn't been worked out because it's all very new and just unraveling, but Sridharji would like to set up a foundation to support young Nepali photographers. So I think that is very exciting, especially to announce today. And he'd like to take that cash award and put it in there, but his family would also like to make an additional contribution of 1,50,000. So the initial seed fund will be of 2 lakhs at the moment. And every year they would like to support young Nepali photographers. So this is very exciting. And आज पनि हाम्रो माझमा आइदिनु भएकोलाई धेरै धेरै धन्यवाद छ श्रीधर जीलाई र विशेष यो फाउन्डेसनको जुन अनाउन्समेन्ट छ मलाई चाहिँ एकदमै खुसी लागेको छ नेपालमा साँच्चै नै अभावै छ नेपाली यंग फोटोग्राफरहरूलाई अलिकति हौसला प्रेरणाको अभावै छ सो यो फाउन्डेसनले चाहिँ हामीसँगै मिलेर धेरै गर्न सक्छौँ भन्ने एकदमै आश लागेको छ त्यसकारण श्रीधरजी यहाँलाई धेरै धेरै एक त बधाई र धन्यवाद पनि अनि विशेष आज फेरि आइदिनु भएकोमा सो वी आर गोइङ टु नाउ स्टार्ट आवर प्यानल वी आर गोइङ टु स्विच बिट्विन इङ्ग्लिस एन्ड नेपाली आई एम गोइङ टु ट्राई माई बेस्ट टु ट्रान्सलेट एज एन्ड वेन आई निड टु बट यस प्लिज फिल फ्री टु दिस इज अ चान्स टु होन योर नेपाली ल्याङ्ग्वेज स्किल्स एज वेल सो थ्याङ्क यू फर जोइनिङ अस वी डिसाइडेड इच इयर एट द फेस्टिभल विड लाइक टु ह्याभ this one slot carved out to discuss local issues, you know, when it comes to photography and photojournalism as much as possible. So it's exciting to have this panel. Yet again, we had a similar one last year. So by way of introduction, I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Dhruba, who's been a practicing photojournalist for over 16 years now. Dhruba started his career with Nepal Samachar Patra. And then has been working for the Himalayan Times now for many, many years. We also have Skanda Gautam here with us.
Thank you.
Skanda has a background in actually graphic design, and he's been working in the field now for 5 years. First with an ad agency, working as a graphic designer, and then as a photographer with started his career at Kantipur. And then is now with the Himalayan Times. And then we have Devaki Bista here. Devaki wears many, many hats. Devaki is incredibly impressive. Devaki started out her career in almost 8 years ago as actually a community and FM radio practitioner. So she started out in the far west Nepal, which is where she's from. Then moved on to television and worked as a television producer. She was handling the camera, she was editing her own material, and she was also presenting and anchoring shows. So, you know, that's a real package right there. And now Devaki has transitioned to working for print media, so it's really that whole spectrum, experience from that whole spectrum that she brings to this panel today, and welcome, and thank you all three of you for joining us. I'd just like to start a little bit, I mean, these were very brief introductions, but A little bit, maybe if each of you could share about your career path, you know, sort of how did you start? What are you doing now? What do you most enjoy doing as part of your job? Maybe we can start with Durbadai and then go down.
As you said that I started from 1999. It's been 16 years. Formally, I was appointed to a broadsheet local national daily. The name is, as she said, Nepal Samajar Patra. And from 2004, I'm working for English broadsheet daily, the Himalayan Times. Before 1999, about 2 or 3 years, I was working as writing journalist also. So, because I've found scope in the field of photojournalism, so I totally quitted writing journalism. So till now, 16 years of my experience, I'm totally satisfied with this photojournalism profession. Why? Because daily I have a chance to expose my creativity. So because of this, I'm totally I'm satisfied with this job. I think he has.
Hi, I'm Skanda Gautam, and I just firstly I want to thank Photo Circle and Photo Kathmandu for giving this big opportunity to me. And I want to start by saying that first I completed my plus two, my high schooling from arts. I was an arts student. Then after that, I was interested in graphic design, advertising and graphic design. And there was, luckily there was this college at WLC, it was in Ratapul. And firstly, I wasn't sure like what was the matter of it, but once I saw the course structure, I thought, yes, I should probably give it a try. So after that, I completed my college from doing graphic design, and I was pretty interested, and like the things were good, and it is more like a multimedia course. Like there's like everything included: photography, graphic design, web designing, videography, everything. And while I was working there, then I got an opportunity to work at a Business Advantage and an advertising agency. And while I was working there, like I just wanted to take photos, you know, like there was the senior Amprandai, Rajbhai Suhaldai. And he used to like take photographs. He was like the client of a Business Advantage, and whenever I used to see his photos, I was like, oh my God, I wish I could also take those photos instead of sitting in my computer all day and, you know, having pan masala. You know, I just I want to go there, explore, take some photos as well. So the first photo I took, there was this product and. There was my teacher, Sachin Yogal Shrestha. He was the creative director of Business Advantage. And he gave me an opportunity to, because he saw me interested in photography, so he gave me an opportunity to take a photo of a product. It was a Bluetooth headset. And it was a pretty simple photo, but I was just learning photography, and I put on my fisheye lens and I took the photo, and when I showed him the photo, he screamed at me. He's like, is this how you shoot a product photography with a fisheye lens? It's all distorted and it's all out of place. And I'm like, oh, okay, sorry. And he's like, do it again. So okay, I do it again. And I was pretty much bored with, fed up with graphic design. So I wanted a career in journalism. And I've heard of all the, I knew the senior photojournalists in Nepal, and I always used to follow their works. And I decided that why not, I can also give it a try. So after that, I got introduced with all the senior journalists, you know, like I had a pretty much background with some of them, and I got introduced and I wanted to start my career. So I started from Kantipur. I worked there for 3 months, and after that, I got an opportunity to work with the Himalayan Times. So since it's been almost two years, I've been in the Himalayan Times working as a photojournalist, basically covering news, culture, politics. Politics mostly is Dhruvadai, but sometimes political development, basically candid feature photos, news, culture. Yeah, that's pretty much it for now. Yeah.
Hello, I'm Devaki. I can't speak well English. Maybe NayanTara will translate my Nepali in English. Ma Devaki. मैले चाहिँ रेडियो पत्रकारिताबाट सुरु गरेको हो जब माओवादीको द्वन्द शान्ति प्रक्रियामा चलिरहेको थियो मेबी 2002 त्यो बेला चाहिँ कम्युनिटी रेडियोमा काम गर्थेँ स्याटेलाइट रेडियो जुन अस्ट्रेलियाबाट ब्रोडकास्ट हुन्थ्यो
नयाँतारा थ्याङ्क यू This is a good plan, keeping it short, letting me translate. I am Devaki Bista. I started my professional practice in community radio in 2002, which is when the Maoist insurgency was ongoing. I was working for a satellite radio station that was broadcast from Australia.
त्यो बेला पनि जब गाउँ गाउँमा जान्थे माओवादीले चाहिँ आर्मी भन्थ्यो आर्मीले चाहिँ माओवादी भनेर चाहिँ धेरै दुःख पाएको थियौँ
When I traveled into villages for work, I would be accused by the army of being Maoist, and I would be accused by the Maoists of being army, and so it was an extremely challenging time to work.
त्यसपछि मेरो पत्रकारिता FM-बाट सुरु भयो, शुक्लफाटा FM.
I started working with शुक्लफाटा FM.
त्यसपछि मेरो राजधानी जुन नेपालको क्यापिटल सिटी भन्छ यहाँ आएर म काम गर्न थालेँ टेलिभिजनमा
एन्ड देन आई मुभ टु काठमाडौँ विच इज द क्यापिटल सिटी एन्ड स्टार्टेड वर्किङ इन टेलिभिजन
त्यसपछि मैले नेपालको 69 अराउन्ड डिस्ट्रिक्टमा घुम्ने मौका पाएँ पत्रकारिताको क्रममा
सिन्स देन आई हेभ ट्राभल टु ओभर 69 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स अराउन्ड नेपाल फर माई वर्क
मैले चाहिँ एउटा राइटर डकुमेन्ट्री मेकर प्रोग्राम प्रेजेन्टर र प्रोग्राम प्रड्युसरको रूपमा काम गरेँ त्यसपछि हिमाल मिडिया र नेपाली टाइम्समा फोटो जर्नलिस्ट र एउटा लेखकको रूपमा पनि काम गरेँ
I've worked as a writer, as a documentary maker, as a television producer and presenter. And since then I've also worked as a print journalist and photographer for हिमाल
अहिले म एउटा डकुमेन्ट्रीमा बिजी भएको कारणले फ्रिलान्सरको रूपमा फोटो जर्नलिस्ट काम गरिरहेको छु
आइ एम करेन्टली वर्किङ अन अ डकुमेन्ट्री फिल्म एन्ड देयरफोर आइ एम फ्रिलान्सिङ एज अ फोटो जर्नलिस्ट एन्ड नट वर्किङ समवेयर फुल टाइम
यो मेरो एउटा प्यासन सँगसँगै एउटा मेरो प्रोफेसनलको रूपमा म यसलाई इस्टाब्लिस गर्न चाहन्छु
आई वुड लाइक टु इस्टाब्लिस माइसेल्फ एज अ प्रोफेसनल फोटोग्राफर एन्ड टेक इट बियोन्ड जस्ट माई प्यासन Okay, I think it's interesting to think about context a little bit because, you know, as we all know, I mean, photography can come from so many places and then go forward into so many different genres, but also in very interdisciplinary ways now. And I feel here in Nepal too, already professionals are beginning to work across mediums across genres and I think that is not just something that has begun to happen in the recent days but that something that has you know sort of been a practice more or less for some time now I mean all of you have been you know started out as a writer graphic design radio community television how do you think that you know all of this experience you know you've shapes what you do now and I mean do you feel that it's important to be able to have these facets or are there times where you feel like oh I wish I would I wish I could concentrate on one particular thing I mean is it about going broad or is it about going deeper you know into something
can I say something okay firstly like when I was doing graphic design my teacher is right over there Mr. Swarup Nasiju he's one of the most influential persons in my life he's inspired me to and he's the one to teach me photography as well and like and I think it's related because when I was doing graphic design when I worked with Mr. Sachin sir like it was kind of connected like I want like, it interests you you know like the things you see behind the advertisement and all and the details and like you wonder how can this be possible and it's like a long process you know it's like a very very long process like once you start to dig in like it's like you get lost you know like it's like oh wow it's crazy And from there, like, photography is definitely related to advertisement, because the photograph, like, it's used in the ad, and after that the process, it continues. So I think for me, the graphics and the photo, like, it kind of linked up for me.
Actually, I interested in this. I earlier said that before 1999, I was doing writing journalism for quite some time, maybe just 3 years. Why I entered journalism was actually because I saw glamour in this field, not only photojournalism, but entire journalism field. Because when I watch BBC and CNN, I saw reporters doing reporting from war zone. So that was actually the luring thing, the attractive part for me, which actually pulled me to this profession. So I quit writing journalism and then started photojournalism, because I later practically knew that in Nepal we have more growing place for photojournalism and scope. I saw scope in this photojournalism, so I quit writing journalism. So in the long term, this is I found this photojournalism here very actually this job as respected by many people also. So we have a lot of respect by people here in Nepal. So and we can every day we can show our creativity. So that's why I'm just quite satisfied till today.
I'd actually like to jump in here 1 second, and ask Devaki this thing about respect. Do you feel like photojournalism or photography or what you do is respected? Do you feel that though?
मैले गर्छु एकदम रेस्पेक्ट गर्छु हैन
जब रेस्पेक्ट अरु मान्छेले रेस्पेक्ट गर्छ जस्तो लाग्छ यो प्रोफेशनले
यस्तो हुन्छ जब मैले मेरो पेसालाई रेस्पेक्ट गर्छु तब अरुले पनि गर्छ त्यो ट्रान्सलेट गर्ने
आई फील that when I respect my profession, other people will respect it as well.
यो फोटोजर्नलिज्म भनेको यस्तो हो एउटा नसा जस्तै हुन्छ कि जब म बाटोमा हिँड्छु मैले बाटोमा बसेर सुतेर पनि फोटो खिच्छु तर कसले मलाई के भन्छ थाहा हुँदैन कसैले हेप्ला हेपेको पनि छ बाटोमा धेरैचोटि चाहिँ जब फोटो खिचिरहेको हुन्छ एउटा केटी मान्छेले बाटोमा फोटो खिच्छ भन्यो भने त्यो को रहेछ के रहेछ भनेर एउटा हेप्ने काम चाहिँ गर्छ होइन जब मेरो कामको आउटपुट बाहिर आउँछ धेरैले चाहिँ ओ यस्तो राम्रो फोटो खिच्यो यो फोटो स्टोरी राम्रो गर्यो भन्ने कुराहरू धेरै बाहिर आउँछ
माई वर्क आई फाइन्ड इज काइन्ड अफ एडिक्टिभ एज आम वर्किङ अन द स्ट्रिट एन्ड आम समटाइम्स लेइङ अन द ग्राउन्ड अर सिटिङ डाउन एन्ड फोटोग्राफिङ एन्ड समटाइम्स पिपल are disrespectful when they see a woman out with a camera working. Sometimes, yes, I do face that, but once they see the output of my work, then I have found that most people show respect.
तर केटी फोटो पत्रकारलाई सहरमा भन्दा गाउँमा देख्दा एकदम अचम्म मान्छन् ओहो केटी मान्छेले पनि यस्तो क्यामेरा समात्छ यो केटा हो कि केटी हो भनेर चाहिँ हेर्न आउँछन् धेरै चाहिँ
आउटसाइड द सिटी इन द रुरल एरियाज इन द विलेजेस व्हेन आई एम आउट एन्ड अबाउट पिपल आर रियली सरप्राइज्ड एन्ड शॉक टु सी अ वुमन विथ अ क्यामेरा एन्ड दे मेक रिमार्क्स लाइक ओ यु नो लाइक इज दिस अ म्यान ओर अ वुमन यु नो देयर इज अ वुमन क्यारिङ अ क्यामेरा सो I mean, this gender thing, I did want to bring this up, obviously. Do you gentlemen feel like Devaki gets more attention in her work because of the fact that she is a woman?
I think we are all equal. I find it the same. Nothing different for me.
So in terms of the presence, we have quite few women photographers in Nepal.
How many?
I think it's
one is woman.
Countable.
What we in Nepali we evra atma ganine, just I think 5 or 6 maybe, I think, who actually professionally or seriously, who is involved seriously. So gender, in terms of the gender ko kura ma chai aba we find quite ekdamai weak presence, but in terms of, not in terms of their work, mm-hmm. but in terms of number.
नम्बर त भयो तर मैले सोध्न खोजेको चाहिँ जस्तो कोही बेला होइन अब सानो थोरै नम्बर भएको कारणले नै ए यो चाहिँ जस्तो अस्ति गफ गर्दाखेरि देवकीले भन्दै थियो कि उसलाई चाहिँ जब अफर आइरहेछ धेरै ए पत्रिकाहरूले पनि हाम्रोमा पनि केटी फोटोग्राफर छ भनेर अलिकति धाक पिट्नलाई पनि होइन जब अफरहरू दिइरहेछ भनेर सो तपाईँहरूलाई त्यसले चाहिँ अलिकति एकदमै च्यालेन्ज गरेको जस्तो लाग्छ कि कस्तो लाग्छ र एक्सेसको कुरामा पनि कोही ठाउँमा मेबी केटी पत्रकार भएको नाताले होइन मान्छेले अलिकति पेट्रोनाइजिङ भएर नै ए यसलाई एक्सेस दिउँ न त भन्ने हिसाबले काम हुन्छ जस्तो लाग्छ कि
आई थिङ्क त्यस मेरो विचारमा त्यस्तो छैन त्यो जेन्डरको इक्वालिटी कुराहरूमा त्यस्तो छैन र त्यो जुन हामीलाई त्यस्तो जुन वुमेन फोटोग्राफरसँग भयो भने हामीलाई झनै किनभने आइडियाजहरू सेयर हुन्छ वाट मेल फोटो जर्नलिस्ट क्यानट क्याप्चर देयर आर सम फ्यु सब्जेक्ट्स विच आई थिङ्क फिमेल फोटोग्राफर क्यान रियली पावरफुल्ली क्याप्चर दोज पिक्चर्स आई थिङ्क
एउटा यो उसमा है लेडिज फोटोग्राफरलाई चाहिँ पहिला मिडिया हाउसमा पत्याउन गाह्रो छ उसले गर्न सक्छ भनेर सायदै कुनै मिडिया हाउसले सोध्छ जब त्यो केटी फिल्डमा गएर चाहिँ राम्रो फोटो राम्रो असाइन गरेर ल्याउँछ उसलाई चाहिँ विश्वास गराउन एकदमै गाह्रो पनि छ अब जस्तो अर्थक्विकमा म हिमालमा काम गर्थेँ त्यो बेला हिमाल र नेपाली टाइम्समा एज अ फोटो जर्नलिस्टको रूपमा काम गर्दाखेरि सायद मेरो लागि त्यो च्यालेन्ज पनि थियो अर्थक्विक आइरहेको थियो मैले चाहिँ फोटोहरू राम्रो राम्रो अब मान्छे मरेको त्यो गर्थेँ स्कुप भन्ने कुराहरू हुन्छ होइन तर त्यो ठाउँमा गएर एउटा खिच्न गाह्रो पनि थियो र मैले एउटा मिडिया हाउससँग मैले चाहिँ गर्न सक्छु भनेर त्यो मेरो लागि च्यालेन्जको रूपमा पनि थियो होइन त्यस्तो च्यालेन्जहरू धेरै ठाउँमा हुन्छ र केटी मान्छेले गर्न सक्छ यदि उसलाई अपर्च्युनिटी दियो भने फोटोग्राफीमा केटी मान्छेहरूलाई चाहिँ च्यालेन्ज पनि छ अपर्च्युनिटी पनि धेरै छ अब अहिले जब मैले गर्न सक्छु म कन्फिडेन्टली भन्न सक्छु म अहिले राम्रो फोटो पत्रकारको रूपमा यो फिल्डमा उभिन सक्छु त्यो कारणले गर्दाखेरि अहिले मलाई धेरै मिडिया हाउसले चाहिँ आऊ गर तिमी फोटो पत्रकारको रूपमा काम गर भनेर अफर पनि आइरहेछ होइन तर म मेरो प्रोजेक्टमा बिजी भएको हुनाले पनि गएको छैन अपर्च्युनिटी दिए भने पो केटी मान्छेले सक्छ कहिलेकाहीँ चाहिँ त्यो स्पेस आफूले पनि बनाउनु पर्छ जस्तो लाग्छ मलाई
ओके आइ एम गोना ट्राई टु समराइज दिस सो वी वर टकिङ अ लिटल बिट अबाउट सर्ट अफ यु नो आई वाज semi-playfully asking the two gentlemen if, you know, if they feel that Devaki, as a woman photojournalist, gets a little bit more attention than they do merely by the fact that she's a woman and perhaps some added opportunities and access opportunities as well. And Devaki's response, well, Turvadai diplomatically said that no, he thinks that everybody is equal. But Devaki was saying that it is a challenge to establish yourself as a woman photojournalist within the professional realm, within media houses. It takes time to establish trust, but once your editors and your colleagues see that you can, you know, perform, that they have been trusting, and she was particularly going back to the experience of reporting after the earthquake, because it was an extremely challenging period at that time, generally, but especially as a woman, the level of confidence within the newsroom is still quite low when it comes to assigning more challenging assignments to women, etc.
Can I say something, NayanTara? Okay, the problem that I've faced in photojournalism when it's been 2 years in THT, and so total around 3 years roughly. The problem that I've faced is like when you're in the field, I mean, like Nepal is pretty much a land of opportunity for culture, you know, agriculture, and you get so many good photographs, you know. There's so much that you can do in Nepal. But when it comes to news events and all, like, there's so many times I've faced it as well, even being a guy, like during the time that they don't understand the real value, you know, of our job. Like, yes, we are respected, but these days, I don't know, for me, I find it sometimes you get abused, your cameras, you know, like they try to snatch your camera, try to like quarrel with you, you know, try to get in a fight with you. Like, especially during the earthquake, that was last year, April 25, 2015. The troubles that I had was like when like the relatives are crying and you know everyone is mourning, you know, the death of their family members, and we are there taking their photos, and I mean, yes, I've been sworn, you know, like they abuse, they are like swear at me, you know, and during that time it gets pretty hard. I mean, it's our job, you know, and like it's our interest, but. Sometimes like it doesn't reflect upon like to those people, like they don't understand the real value of what it means. Like we're just trying to show like through a photograph, you know, like maybe get them help or aid, you know, like something can be done for them, because if we don't do that, then I think there's no value of it, like, you know, they will never get help. And those are the things that people don't understand in Nepal. Like sometimes the people are pretty much behind in when it comes to these kind of things.
So just to piggyback off of that, Skanda, what do you think is the difference of being, you know, somebody, a local photographer? Let's say we talk about the earthquake, okay. The experience of covering this earthquake that we went through last year. All of us have lives here, we have families here, you know, but we still have these jobs we need to do. But what do you think was the difference between what you were doing then and what somebody else was doing when they were flying in, etc.? What kind of challenges did you have? But also, I mean, were there things you could do because you were local?
I think the castes and all, I don't think it really matters, but there are times when, like, being a Newar guy from the Newar community, I think that helps you pretty much in many situations, like, because they are mostly Newari people, like, you see around, you know, when you, in mostly main events. But so for me, I don't think it really matters, but sometimes, yes, if you, like, know the languages, you know, like, the local languages, like even if you're Nepali, there are like so many other languages as well. So I think if you know some of those languages, then it could be helpful at situations. But for me, when I'm in the field, they think I'm a tourist. They think I'm from America, and you know, they're like, oh, Bidesi is American, you know, like, what is he doing here? And I'm like, no, I'm Nepali, man. Like, oh, hey, Nepali po rahe, so you're like a brother, oh, okay, you know. So it's not that problematic, but like I said earlier, like at times you get like bullied, you know, you get offended, and it's pretty bad. But I think now I'm used to it, you know, like because like I mean.
I think in terms of my own, I have two kind of experience, like. Because I have family also, because I am a local, so I have to look after my family also. Because after earthquake, there were series of thousands of aftershocks. So, in one hand, I have to protect my family. I have to make ready all the daily need supplies also. And other hand, I have to complete my office assignments also. So, these are my two kind of experiences, but in terms of because I am a local, I know I understand every news, where the people are suffering. I know better than photojournalists arriving from abroad. So this is a benefit for me as a local photojournalist.
मेरो चाहिँ फ्यामिली यहाँ थिएन अर्थक्विकको बेला जब अर्थक्विक आयो म सुन्दारा पुगेँ सुन्दारामा चाहिँ मान्छेहरू मरेर चाहिँ पुरै लासै लास राखिरहेको थियो म त्यहाँनिर पुगेँ एउटा केटा रोइरहेको थियो मलाई यस्तो त्यहाँनिर चाहिँ यस्तो अप्ठ्यारो पऱ्यो म फोटो खिचौँ अथवा उसलाई सम्झाउने
माई फ्यामिली वाज नट हियर वेन द अर्थक्वेक स्ट्रक When the earthquake struck, I went to Sundara, which is in the center of the city where we have this tall tower that collapsed and there were hundreds of people, I think over 100 people who died. When I reached Sundara, there were dead bodies lying on the ground and there was a boy sitting and crying. And it was a real challenge for me. I wasn't sure whether I should photograph him or to sit down and comfort him.
वीर हस्पिटलमा त्यो केटा बसिरहेको थियो अनि मैले सम्झाउन पनि सकिनँ फोटो खिच्न पनि सकिनँ त्यो बेला मैले पहिला चाहिँ अब म फोटो खिच्नकै लागि आएको छु मेरो प्रोफेसन हो भनेर मैले फोटो खिचेँ उसले बट यहाँबाट उता जा भन्छ रुदा रुदै
This boy was outside Bir Hospital and I was unable to do either. I couldn't comfort him and I couldn't take a photograph either. And so I really wasn't sure what to do. And then I went there to take photos, so I tried to do that. But then he tried to chase me away because he was clearly in trauma.
Scarred. त्यसपछि मलाई फोटो खिच्न पनि गाह्रो भयो मैले फोटो खिचेँ त्यहाँदेखि गएँ फोटो खिचेर त्यो त्यहीँनिर रोइरहेको थियो अब कहिलेकाहीँ यस्तो सिचुएसन पनि आउँछ जब मान्छे मरिरहेको हुन्छ त्यो आँसु पनि हाम्रो लागि एउटा न्युज बन्छ कि त्यो आँसु उसको रोएको जति रुन्छ त्यति रोएको हामीलाई न्युज आउँछ भनेर रोकै राम्रो लाग्छ तर त्यो सिचुएसन एकदमै गाह्रो हुन्छ यस्तो धेरै सिचुएसनहरू पऱ्यो यो जर्नालिजमको सेक्टरमा तर पनि त्यो बेला स्ट्रङ भएर बाहिर निस्कनु पर्छ जस्तो मलाई लाग्छ
सो दिज सिचुएसन्स आर भेरी च्यालेन्जिङ बिकज tragedy is very tragic for the person but it's news for our profession and tears make news and headlines so often we go looking for this drama but these are extremely challenging situations and but I do feel that we have to come out of all of this stronger
एउटा अर्को मेरो लाइफमा चाहिँ एकदमै बिर्सन नसकिने घटना पनि हो दुईवटा घटना छ जुन मैले फोटो पत्रकारिताको क्रमबाट त्यो लेडिजको लाइफलाई चाहिँ एकदमै राम्रो बनाउन सकेँ मलाई जब म मेरो क्यामेरा र मेरो रिपोर्टिङ राइटिङको उसमा जान्छु एकदमै खुसी लाग्छ मलाई काभ्रेको केस हो उसलाई चाहिँ उसको बुवा र हजुरबुवा र बुवाले 8 वर्षदेखि रेप गरिरहेको थियो अनि म चाहिँ स्टिङ अपरेसनको लागि काभ्रेको त्यो धुलीखेल हस्पिटलमा पुगेँ र मसँग मेरो स्किल थियो क्यामेराले गर्दा मैले उसको हस्पिटलमा सबै रेकर्डिङ गरेँ म त्यो बेला चाहिँ पत्रकार भन्दा पनि पुलिस इन्सपेक्टर भनेर गएको थिएँ किनभने त्यो सिचुएसनमा म पत्रकार अथवा फोटो पत्रकार भनेको भए मलाई त्यहीँ पिटेर राख्थ्यो होला मैले सबै प्रुफहरू कलेक्सन गरेँ त्यो गरिसकेपछि मैले हिमालमा हाम्रो एडिटरलाई सबै पठाइसकेको थिएँ 3G र पहिला नै इन्फर्म गरिसकेको थिएँ मेरो त्यो रिपोर्टिङले हिमालमा जब मैले लेखेँ उसको बुवाले 17 वर्ष जेल सजाय पायो मसँग प्रुफ थियो उसको फोटो जुन त्यो केटी त्यो हस्पिटलमा बसेको थियो त्यो मेरो स्किलले गर्दा हो जस्तो लाग्छ अनि त्यसपछि उसको हजुरबुवाले चाहिँ 20 सेवन गरेर मर्यो र अहिले त्यो केटी एउटा संस्थामा छ अहिले ऊ डक्टर बन्न खोज्छ र आफू जस्तै रेप केसमा परेको केटीहरूलाई एउटा काउन्सिलिङ गरेर इम्पावरमेन्ट गर्छ उसले त्यो के लाग्छ भने मैले मेरो फोटो पत्रकारिताबाट र मेरो लेखाइबाट चाहिँ उसको लाइफलाई रेस्क्यु गरेर यहाँसम्म पुऱ्याएर उसले चाहिँ अब ऊ जस्तै रेपमा परेको धेरै केटीहरूलाई इम्पावरिङ गरेर एउटा अगाडि ल्याउँछ
There have been some incidents and assignments that I take satisfaction from. There was one particular case where I was part of a sting operation in Kavre, where a young girl was there after having suffered of being raped by her father and her grandfather for the last 8 years. Mm. And I was there to cover as part of this sting operation. I was there as a police officer because if I had been there as a photojournalist, I would have probably been beaten up and kept there and not allowed to do what, not allowed to cover this incident. But this coverage, which was later published in Himal Khabar Patrika, resulted in a 17-year jail sentence for the father. And unfortunately, the grandfather, it seems, committed suicide. But this girl was rescued, and she's currently studying to be a doctor, and is also works as a counselor for other rape survivors.
यस्तै अर्को घटना पनि छ जस्तो मैले थोरै समय फोटो पत्रकारिता गरे पनि मेरो फोटोले गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ धेरै ठाउँमा धेरै राम्रो पनि भयो यो म एउटा गर्व गर्न चाहन्छु केटीहरूको लागि फोटो पत्रकारिता च्यालेन्ज पनि छ एउटा एक्सपेन्सिभ पनि छ जस्तो लाग्छ जुन ठाउँबाट आएर चाहिँ मैले यहाँ फोटो पत्रकारिता सुरु गरेँ त्यसमा कम्पिटिसन गर्नलाई गाह्रो पनि थियो तर मैले गर्दै गएँ अहिले चाहिँ मलाई फोटो पत्रकारितामा खुसी छु म सेटिस्फाई छु किनभने मेरो एउटा एउटा फोटोले चाहिँ जति खिची छु उनीहरूको लाइफ बनेको छ
इट्स फोटो जर्नलिज्म इज अ एक्सपेन्सिभ करियर आई
गर्ल्स
Especially for girls, I guess this is just to add a little bit of context. We were talking about this earlier. You know, one needs to invest in a camera that is not less than whatever, $1,000. Mm-hmm. One needs to invest in a motorbike. These are sort of the two key requirements, it seems, to get a job as a photojournalist.
Yeah, and when it comes to job, yes, you need a motorbike. You need a nice camera, a good lens. You know, you can. Like even the editors, they want to see your things, you know, your what gear you have, your weapons, you know, like, and that's how they're pretty much impressed. Like once you have all that things, then they're happy. They're like, okay, you come for the job.
But to segue back into what Devaki was saying, she was saying that it's been an investment and it's been a challenge, but she feels happy to see sort of the impact that she's been able to make on, you know, some lives as an outcome of sort of the reporting that she's been able to do.
Photo patrakarita ma, photo patrakarlai dherai thau ma chai hepna pani khojcha. Tyo maile feel pani garechu. Euta media house ma pani reporterlai photo patrakarsang garne byahar chai maile feel garechu. Kinabhane maile chai writing ma pani mero skill bhaunale chai maile tyo hepai feel garna sakchu. Photo patrakarle photo matra khichcha. तर राइटिङ बिगर देन फोटो पत्रकार के फोटो पत्रकार त त्यो फिल्डमा गएर फोटो खिचेर ल्याउनु पर्छ नि रिपोर्टरलाई थाहा हुँदैन ए त्यहाँ त्यस्तो छ जा त भन्छ तर जो जा भन्छ नि उसलाई चाहिँ थाहा हुँदैन त्यहाँ के हुन्छ भनेर
सो देयर इज अ हायरार्की विथ बिट्विन जर्नलिस्ट्स एन्ड फोटो जर्नलिस्ट्स द्याट वी एक्सपिरियन्स समहाउ द राइटर्स अलवेज सिम टु गेट मोर रिस्पेक्ट but the writer usually is on the phone and gathering reporting over the phone whereas it is the photojournalist who's actually out there I'd like to now switch over a little bit to you know from talking about these challenges to perhaps talking a little bit about opportunities as well the fact that you know the photojournalists are the first ones there you know to be able to report and capture news etc what do you think is happening in terms of photojournalism here in Nepal I mean Dhruba you've had 17 years of experience how do you think as technology changes you know as other things change what has been like the biggest sort of change for you as a photojournalist here
In terms of technology, there is a very big change we find because we are now carrying latest model of camera, latest technology, digital camera, in terms of technology. But in terms of placement of photograph in, because I'm working in broadsheet daily, we have very minor development because every day we have to fight with desk editors to publish our good picture and we have very surface level of problems, like we have a problem of picture being cropped by designers. We have problems of pictures being given very small, small space, and if the picture is really, I mean, quite good, so if there is lots of ad that day, the picture won't be published because they are, interested to earn money by publishing ads and not by good picture. So this is a surface level of challenge in Nepali photojournalism.
Any other additions in terms of specific challenges, or but then also opportunities? Yes. Maybe
Opportunities are pretty much less, I think, for me. Opportunities, yes, you get the name, you get the fame, and people know you, you're happy, you're satisfied, or you're like, oh, you took a good photo, yeah, everyone is happy. And, you know, and it gives you, you know, satisfaction as well, like when your family members. I remember my first photo, it was published, it was like this small, it was so small, and it was of a railing bridge, you know, and it's like a small photo, but there was my name, and my family's like, oh, your photo is published, and I'm like, my photo is published, yeah. And yeah, that's the kind of happiness, like, you know, the small things that which make you that makes you happy, you know, like those are the opportunities. And the challenges, yes, there's a lot of challenges about the camera, you know, the insurance, and like, you know, like you have to worry, like if something is happening, you have to take care of your camera, because if it gets broken, then your family members start screaming at you. Like, why did you break the camera? You know, all these kind of issues we have.
Great. I think I'd like to open it up now. I mean, we have three experienced practitioners here. If you'd like to know a little bit more about the scene, we'll take questions for a few minutes. Happy to translate if necessary.
You can take questions.
नेपालीमा बोलौँ. सो म ठ्याक्कै फोटो पत्रकार त परिनँ, तर एकदमै स्टाब्लिस तिनजना फोटो पत्रकारहरूको कुरा सुन्दा, फोटो पत्रकारिता लभर, फोटोग्राफी लभर भएको कारणले म केही कुरा थाहा पाउन चाहन्छु तिनैजनाबाट. एकदम छातीमा हात राखेर भनिदिनुहोस्, तपाईँहरू एकदम खुसी हुन्छौँ हाम्रो प्रोफेसनबाट भनिराख्नु भएको छ. भाइलाइन आउँछ, त्यसले गर्दा हाम्रो परिवारमा पनि सुख खुसी छाउँछ. अनि त्यसपछि यो च्यालेन्जहरू जसरी ध्रुवा आलेजीले भन्नुभयो, सुरुमै उहाँ कसरी आकर्षित हुनुभएछ भने इन्टरनेसनल फोटो जर्नालिस्टहरूको कामलाई हेरेर, उनीहरूले वारमा काम गरेको, उनीहरूको बडो एडभेन्चरस कामहरू, इक्विपमेन्टहरू देखेर आकर्षित हुनुभएछ. त्यस्तै देवकी बिष्टको आफ्नो कथा छ, तर तपाईँहरूको आफ्नो व्यक्तिगत कथा आफूसँग पनि छ. तपाईँहरूले गरेको फोटो पत्रकारिताबाट, त्योभन्दा पहिला हामीले यहाँहरूका फोटोहरू धेरै दैनिक पत्र पत्रिकाहरूमा हेर्ने गर्छौँ, खुसी छौँ यहाँहरूको नाम देख्दा, काम देख्दाखेरि. तर मलाई व्यक्तिगत सधैँ त्यो आशंका छाइरहेको छ, तपाईँहरूको नाम र काम सँगसँगै तपाईँहरूको रोजीरोटी चाहिँ त्यो फोटोग्राफीबाट, त्यो फोटो पत्रकारिताबाट, त्यो मिडिया हाउसबाट साँच्चै फुलफिल भएको छ कि छैन होला. त्यो ठुलो मिडिया हाउसहरू दिनदिनै नयाँ मेसिनहरू किनेको खबर सुन्नमा आउँछ, उहाँहरूको चाहिँ नि एकदम अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय ठुला ठुला सम्मेलनहरूमा भाग लिएको खबर आउँछ, उहाँहरूका नयाँ नयाँ ब्रान्चेजहरू रेडियो भएकाहरूको पत्रिका खुल्छ, पत्रिकाहरूको टेलिभिजन खुल्छ. तर भर्खरै फोटो पत्रकार साथीले भन्नुभयो, आफ्नो मोटरसाइकल अनि क्यामेरा छ भने त्यो मिडिया हाउसले छिट्टो काम गर्नको लागि बोलाउँछ. यो कति पनि नडाटिकन भनिदिनुहोस्, तपाईँहरूको शुभचिन्तक भएर सोध्दैछु, तपाईँहरूको आफ्नो मिडिया हाउसले अथवा यहाँ धेरै फोटो पत्रकारहरू हुनुहुन्छ होला, उहाँहरू आफूले गरेको फोटो पत्रकारिताबाट साँच्चै साँझ बिहानको गुजारा नाम जस्तै गरी खुसीसँग गुजारिएको छ होला.
So the question was if they are truly happy with their jobs.
Actually, in terms of earning here in Nepal, we have very less opportunity here because we have very few publication houses and very few staff photographers in those publication houses because business is not in growing stage here in Nepal. So this is the byproduct of publication houses not getting lots of ads. So I think because of business, publication houses are not getting not earning lot, so they cannot hire lots of photojournalists, and they cannot pay enough salary for those staff photographers. And here we have different kind of situations. Like in Nepal, I think there is very less opportunity for freelance photographers because lots of publication houses, they are not able to pay for those freelance photojournalists. And there are lots of writing journalists here who also work as photojournalists themselves with their compact cameras, and many of them now with their mobile cameras. And because publication houses, they cannot appoint too much photojournalists here. Particularly in my publication house, the Himalayan Times, we have only six staff photographers right now working, but we have started about 8 or 9 years from it, and 8 or 9 years we are starting beat photojournalism. So among six, one of our for journalists, he only shoots sports. One only covers business events. One who only covers this entertainment events. And me, as he earlier said, I only cover political news. And I think Skanda, he also covers feature news. And so,
but the question was, are you truly happy, Dhruba, with your job?
Yeah, actually, right now I'm actually happy, but I think the salary we get from our publication house or media house is not that satisfactory. To earn a lot, I think we have to also manage for outside projects. I think that is also an important factor, I think.
And is that, just to go into that a little bit deeper, is that possible as a full-time photojournalist at a newspaper? Can you also work outside?
No, working outside is not easy in Nepal because we have less photo projects, and it's not that, big cash. There is very less money for those projects. And in terms of management, media house management, till now, very few media houses are providing their own camera and equipment to their photojournalists. Because as Skanda said earlier, we are, buying our equipment by ourselves, and we are when it gets trouble, so we are paying from our own pocket to for maintenance. So it's really challenging in terms of paying scale.
We were having a little bit of a conversation some time ago, and the average starting salary for a photojournalist in a Nepali paper is around 15,000 rupees per month. To start for that job, one needs a camera that costs at least 1,50,000 maybe. You know, you invest in some lenses and a good backpack, and then you need a laptop, and then you need that motorbike to get along, etc. So you're looking at an initial investment of at least 3-4 lakhs. And so how many, I mean, I'll let you do the math, how many months is it going to take to cover that initial investment? That is just on a, you know, practical sort of equipment kind of a level. But yeah, these challenges do exist. I don't know if either of you want to give very brief answers to Jagdishai's question about, you know, whether you're really happy, and then we'll move on.
Okay, actually, I'm very happy. But if you don't have support from your family, or if you don't have any background, financially, then it's very difficult. Because you need family support, especially to upgrade your cameras, your lenses. And for me, it's my interest and it's what I love to do. So I'm happy because I get to do what I want. But yes, financially it's not enough. We have difficulties, especially because I'm married. I just got recently married and my wife, she asks me money. I'm like, oh, sorry, I have no money. Yes. There are those difficult times as well. But yes, when you get projects from outside, sometimes, you know, it's like a lottery. You earn enough, you know, it's good, but it finishes so soon that you don't even realize it. Yes, it's difficult, it's challenging, but moreover, if you have support and if during times of difficulties there is someone behind to help you, then yes, I think you should go for it, and I encourage the young people to go for it.
You know, you can ask your wife for money too, you know.
Yeah, but she's studying right now, so it's difficult.
Jagdishai, I'm happy in the sense of photo, social issue. Not happy in the media house salary. Kinabane photo patrakar ko eti dherai kaam huncha ki त्यो मिडिया हाउस को सैलरी जुन दिन्छ नि त्यो यताउता जादैमा पेट्रोलमा क्यामेरा बिग्रिदैमा ठिक्क हुन्छ त्यही कारणले गर्दाखेरि म अहिले फ्रीलान्सर को रूपमा पनि काम गरिरा छु म पत्रकारिता को छैन ज्याक अफ अल छु के त्यही भएर गाह्रो छैन मलाई
देवकी इज ह्याप्पी बट शी इज ह्याप्पी विथ हर वर्क बट शी इज नॉट ह्याप्पी विथ द वे you know, this profession is structured institutionally. The monthly salary of a photojournalist is barely enough to pay for petrol and to pay for camera repairs. Therefore, she takes on a lot of freelance assignments as well. And it's really helpful that she is a jack of all, and that she's able to do these other jobs on the side to sustain herself. Maybe we go to another question. I think I saw a hand back there, but yeah. Kishore Dai, and then I'll come to.
Hello. Skanda bhai bhai. Sayad wahan le chinnu hunna hola malai. Mero naam chai Kishore Kaasta. Probably esto photographic program ma probably maile 19 barsha pachi pahilo patak question gardaichu hola. Normally maile kahile pani questions har gardina. Malai ma basera bolchu. Please don't mind. मेरो चाहिँ सानैदेखि नै एकदम क्युरियोसिटी फोटोग्राफीमा मेरो पहिलो फोटो पत्रिकामा आजभन्दा 18 वर्ष अगाडि विकास रोनियार भन्ने दाइले एउटा फोटो ल्याबबाट लिएर गएर छापिदिनु भएको थियो एक्चुली मलाई थाहा पनि थिएन अनि म दङ्गै परेको थिएँ कान्तिपुरमा फोटो छापियो 18 वर्ष अगाडि अनि मलाई पैसाको लागि बोलाए 200 रुपियाँ पाएको थिएँ दङ्गै परेको थिएँ अनि प्रबली त्यो 18 इयर्समा कहिले पनि मेरो पत्रिकामा मेरो फोटो छापिएको छैन तर त्यो टाइममा प्रायली मलाई फोटो जर्नलिजममा त्यति नलेज नभए होला इन्सपायर विकास साइसनतिरै हुन्थे कुराहरू गरिन्थ्यो म चाहिँ फाइन आर्ट फोटोग्राफी गर्छु भक्तपुर सिरिज गरेँ मैले लास्ट 20 इयर्स 25 इयर्स भक्तपुर मात्र खिचेँ कम्प्लिट भक्तपुर मात्र मैले 12 वर्ष खिचेँ भक्तपुरभन्दा बाहिर कहिले पनि जान्न थिएँ अनि बिस्तारै आई मुभ इन्टु डिफ्रेन्ट फोटोग्राफी I became a fashion photographer. I call it myself, Fashion Wala Babu. Then I start shooting landscape. shooting landscape, I find myself is a porter photographer who can carry camera and the right time, right moment. I couldn't change my country through my work. I think, but I'm happy with my work. And I move into a lot of category. मैले धेरै किसिमको कामहरू गर्थेँ नेपालमा फाइन आर्ट फोटोग्राफीलाई माथि ल्याउनुपर्छ भनेर आई ट्राई टु डु लट अफ स्टाफ बट सिङ यु गाइज ग्ल्यामर्स स्टेजमा रमाइलो हुँदो रहेछ सो आई थिङ्क मलाई कता कता फोटो जर्नलिजम पनि गर्नु मन लाग्यो बट आई हेभ नो आइडिया फोटो जर्नलिजम भनेको के हो कस्तो फोटो खिच्नेलाई जर्नलिस्ट भन्छ फोटो खिचेर त्यो न्युज बनाउने त सायद जगिस दाईले पनि गर्नुहुन्थ्यो सगरमा संसारभरि पपुलर छ उहाँ त पक्कै पनि जर्नलिस्ट होइन अनि जात्राहरू मैले के खिच्छु सम्भवतः कुनै पनि जर्नलिस्टले मलाई एज अ जर्नलिस्ट फोटोग्राफर एक्सेप्ट गर्दैन होला कस्तो टाइपको फोटो खिच्यो भने फोटो जर्नलिस्ट हुन्छ मलाई एकदमै फोटो जर्नलिस्ट बन्नु मन लाग्यो अब चाहिँ नेक्स्ट मेरो हुन्छ नि ल्यान्डस्केप पछि फ्यासन खिचेँ सबै पिपुल कलिङ मी एज अ फ्यासन फोटोग्राफर आई हेट द्याट वर्ड because I'm not a fashion photographer, I'm just a photographer. So, वहाँ Dhruba जीलाई देखेर एकदमै भयो कि मलाई पनि अब यस्तो ग्ल्यामर चाहियो मलाई पनि यस्तो मिडियातिर हिँड्नु मन लाग्यो सो मैले कस्तो टाइपको काम गर्नु पऱ्यो र मैले पत्रिकामा काम गर्न मेरो प्रोसेस के हुनुपर्छ मैले के गर्दा म फोटो जर्नलिस्ट हुन्छु
I think Mr. Kishore Ka is an extremely established fashion photographer within quotes. He's applying for a job.
Yeah. Yeah, the answer is simple. Here in Nepal, take pictures of political personalities and that would actually make you quick photojournalist here in Nepal, I think. But actually, the basic... Hajur, hajur. Oh. Hajur. हजुर हो एक्चुली जस्ट सिम्पल एन्सर छ यसमा द फोटोग्राफ सुड कन्टेन न्युज एन्ड ह्यापनिङ द्याट्स न्युज फोटो फर अस सिम्पल एन्सर आई थिङ्क
बट वाट वाज योर क्वेस्चन एक्ज्याक्टली यु आर आस्किङ देम यु नो वाट इट मिन्स टु बी अ फोटो जर्नलिस्ट
ओके Kishore Dai like is one of the most senior fashion photographers and I appreciate his all of his works his creativity and I remember working with his friend his Dai Sachin Yogal Shrestha and always seeing Kishore Dai's photographs always amused me and for the thing that I can say to Kishore Dai is you should always go through the calendar you know for the upcoming events like what's happening next talk to each other on the phone you know like hey ke program chha ki chaina is there anything you know and you just explore you travel ani tespachi tapai ko aba kaha ke ghatna haru any news events anywhere and you just follow that and jani khichne alikati fast aba tei ta ho ni ani alikati different aba tyo bhayo bhane huncha kinaki hamro history in photojournalism khase aba behind is kinaki pahila dekhi to education system ma pani khase yo naganine nai एउटा कोर्स थियो जस्तो लाग्छ मलाई चाहिँ पहिलादेखि नै होइन अनि त्यही भएर अलिकति आई थिङ्क वी आर बिहाइन्ड अरू कन्टेक्स्टमा चाहिँ बट आई थिङ्क अब त्यही नै हो दाइ
मलाई त केही छैन किनभने यो क्वेसन चाहिँ एकदम सिम्पल छ तर डेफिनेसन दिन गाह्रो छ कि
Kishore Dai, you don't need to come to this field. You're great as it is. So.
Stay away.
I don't think it's necessary.
No, but I think for me, this question is an important one because I mean, I don't mean it in the sense, what is the process? What do I apply for a job, etc. But I think it is a valid question, you know, as photojournalists.
You guys just continue as calling me as a fashion photographer, which is right. For me, it's insulting, right? So you've been seeing my work last 25 years in Nepal. So I've been working for ECS. So I've traveled entire Nepal. I've done a lot of documentaries. I've shot Maoist work. So I've been doing the story on Dal community. I've traveled, I've shot. Although, as Skanda said, I've been shooting all the festivals, all the events, except news that we were caught the ribbons. Except ribbon cutting, I've covered all kind of photography in Nepal.
Yeah, so I think it's an interesting question because I think it is good to reflect on, you know, what it is that we do. It's interesting, like, is it the fact that a newspaper hires us, does that make us a photojournalist? I mean, does that automatically, is that the only sort of qualification, you know, or the fact that, you know, you're just, you show up, you're fast, you make some calls, you get there, you cover an event. What are we saying with our work? What are we doing in terms of sort of, you know, longer term practices? These are all interesting, I think, and important questions. As we look back, as we work, I mean, at this festival, there are all these workshops and portfolio reviews, and we've invited a lot of local photographers to come to these portfolio reviews, and sometimes many of them are saying to us that we don't have portfolios. We've been, you know, working for so many years, as in, you know, a body of work that we might want to sort of develop further, etc. So these are, I think, important sort of, and it's difficult when it's on a day-to-day basis, I think, you know, you're covering one event to the other, you're sort of like on a roll, but then to stop and be able to take stock of what it is that we do as professionals, I think is quite important. I think we have time for maybe one or two more questions, yes.
Hi, I wanted to ask how you choose. There's an ethical issue in photojournalism, like you, there's a very thin line on how you select your subjects. For example, when ma'am was talking about how she ran away from the earthquake victim, but she went and took a picture of a rape woman. So how do you weigh the trauma and select this I should photograph and this I should not? Will that come out of experience or personal choice or what? How? A sting operation for a rape victim, but just because a trauma victim, like, it's a different kind of trauma, right? So how do you choose that?
यो केसमा भन्ने पर्ने हुन्छ यो केसमा चाहिँ कस्तो भयो भने यो मेरो चुजको विषय पनि हो म सोसल इस्युमा एकदम इन्ट्रेस्टेड छु केही समय अगाडि उसको मसँग भेट भएको थियो र त्यसको लागि एउटा प्रुफ पनि कलेक्सन गर्नुपर्छ किनभने जर्नालिजममा चाहिँ विदाउट प्रुफ हामी केही पनि गर्न सक्दैनौँ कसैले पनि केही पनि भन्न सक्छ होइन त्यो कारणले गर्दाखेरि मैले उसको प्रुफ कलेक्सन गरेँ जुन प्रुफहरू हामीले एउटा इथिकली जर्नालिजमको रुल अनुसार इथिकली बाहिर ल्याउन सक्ने कुराहरूलाई बाहिर ल्यायौँ र नल्याउने कुरालाई ल्याएनौँ जस्तो अब त्यो रेप भिक्टिम केटी जुन छ उसको फोटोलाई पब्लिस गरेनौँ उसको फोटो जब पब्लिस गऱ्यौँ त्यो बेला चाहिँ फेसमा मोजेक गराएको थियो उसको फेसलाई ब्लर गरिदिएको थियो त्यो सबै मिडिया हाउसमा दिएन अनि सायद नेपालमा पहिलोपटक होला छोरीलाई रेप गर्ने बुवाको फोटो चाहिँ पब्लिस भएको जुन हाम्रो हिमालमा भयो तर त्यसमा पनि मिडियाको रुल अनुसार त्यो फोटो देखाउन मिल्ने थिएन र उसको फोटो पनि ब्लर गरियो कहिलेकाहीँ आफ्नो प्रोफेसनल एक्सपिरियन्सले पनि काम गर्छ त्यहाँ र जर्नालिजमको इथिकली जुन रुलहरू हुन्छ त्यो रुल पनि फलो गर्नुपर्छ इट्स डिपेन्ड अन सिचुएसन के सिचुएसन अनुसार पनि काम गर्नुपर्छ त्यो भनेअनुसार हुँदैन कहिलेकाहीँ
So I think Devaki was saying that for her it's also an issue, it's also an interest, a personal interest, like based on what to cover. Devaki is very interested in social issues and so for her the topics she chooses to work in is very much determined by that. But of course ethics within journalism exists and so in the case of the rape case, the identity of the rape survivor was not disclosed and her face was blurred. It was probably the first time in the history of Nepal that the father the rapist, who happens to be the father of the rape survivor, was given this jail sentence and his photograph was published in a news magazine. However, his photo was also blurred, and so as per the rule of the magazine, his face was not shown.
क्वेसन गर्छु मेरो चाहिँ अघि जेन्डर सम्बन्धी त्यहाँ डिस्कस भएको थियो अनि क्वेसन ध्रुव दाईले चाहिँ यसमा सब इक्वेल छ भन्नुभयो त्यस म चाहिँ त्यसमा एग्री छैन जस्तै मैले नि मेरो धेरै साथी सिनियर दाईहरूले नै अब अहिले म जहाँ गरिरहेको छु त्यहाँ मलाई प्रब्लम छैन र मैले अन्त गर्नु पनि म 10 पटक सोच्नुपर्छ त्यहाँ केटीहरूलाई कस्तो इन्भाइरोमेन्ट छ भनेर साँच्ची नै ध्रुव दाई इक्वेल छ केटा र केटी फोटोग्राफ फोटो पत्रकार र तपाईँहरूमा बस यो मात्रै क्वेसन हो मेरो अघि जुन तपाईँले ओभरअल भन्नुभयो साँच्ची नै छ
इन टर्म्स अफ जेन्डर इक्वालिटी इन टर्म्स अफ अपर्च्युनिटी फोटो एक्सेसको आई थिङ्क देयर इज इक्वल अपर्च्युनिटी फर आई थिङ्क बोथ मेल एन्ड फिमेल आई थिङ्क इन टर्म्स अफ अर्निङ त्यो त मलाई त्यति ऊ छैन जानकारी छैन इन टर्म्स अफ अपर्च्युनिटी आई थिङ्क त्यो त इक्वल नै छ जस्तो लाग्छ तर लाइक नेपालमा अब महिलाहरूलाई अब यो एकदमै च्यालेन्जिङ फिल्ड भएको भएर पनि अब त्यही अब उसको कुरा गरौँ आज नि जस्तै फाइनेन्सियल कुराहरूले गर्दा पनि त्यो एउटा च्यालेन्ज छ जस्तो लाग्छ मलाई स्पेसली फिमेल फोटोग्राफर्सहरूलाई
म यसमा चाहिँ एउटा कुरा जोड्छु जस्तो म महिला फोटो पत्रकार भएको हुनाले उमा पनि काम गरिरहेको छ यसमा होइन अभियसली धेरै च्यालेन्जहरू छ उमाले भन्यो नि जस्तो म अन्नपूर्ण छोडेर अर्कोमा जान्छु भन्यो नि एकदम सोच्नुपर्छ म हिमाल र नेपाली टाइम्समा मैले काम गरेँ म प्राउड फिल गर्छु कि जस्तो त्यो कुनै पनि मिडिया हाउसको चाहिँ मान्छे त्यो मान्छेमा डिपेन्ड हो कि उसको चाहिँ नेचर त्यो भन्ने कुराहरू योभन्दा अगाडि म एउटा मिडिया हाउसमा काम गर्थेँ त्यहाँ मेरो फोटो पत्रकार साथीहरू केटाहरू थियो म केटी थिएँ उनीहरू मलाई के गर्थ्यो भने उनीहरू आफ्नो पैसा आउने ठाउँमा उनीहरू जाने अनि पैसा नआउने ठाउँमा जुन असाइन हुन्छ नि डेली मलाई कुदाउँथ्यो कि त्यो पनि कस्तो डिस्टेन्स छ भने 5 मिनटमा म एयरपोर्टको असाइनमा गएको छु भने मसँग स्कुटर थिएन क्यामेरा थियो त्यो 5 मिनटमा चाहिँ मलाई त्योभन्दा विपरीत ध्रुवमा जा भनेर मलाई फोन गर्ने कि उनीहरूले अनि स्कुटर नभएको हुनाले मलाई चाहिँ कस्तो भने हाम्रो डेडलाइनमा चाहिँ डेली पेपर थियो 12-1 बजीसम्म बस्नु पर्थ्यो जहिले उनीहरू मेरो पालोमा मलाई 12-1 बजीसम्म बस भन्ने अनि त्यो गाडी घर जाँदाखेरि गाडी पनि ड्राइभर हुन्थेन अनि उसले चाहिँ ड्रिङ्क्स गरेको हुन्थ्यो अनि मैले बसिराख्नु पर्थ्यो कि कसैको बाइकमा जाने हो भने नि बाइकमा बस्यो नि अलिक अगाडि बसन भन्ने के अनि यो कारणले चाहिँ मैले आफूले आफैलाई नै एकदम क्यापेबल बनाएँ कि बाइक पनि मैले आफै चलाउनु सिकेँ जब मलाई कसैले चाहिँ अगाडि बस्न भन्यो भने म चलाउँछु त पछाडि बस्न भन्थेँ कि म क्यामेराको सन्दर्भमा पनि त्यही हो धेरै ठाउँमा यस्तो अप्ठ्यारो सिचुएसनमा मलाई काम गर्नु पर्यो जसले गर्दाखेरि म आज आफूलाई चाहिँ जुनसुकै ठाउँमा पनि म काम गर्न सक्छु के खुसी लाग्छ जस्तो उमाले काम गरिरहेछ उमाले पनि एकदमै राम्रो गरिरहेछ थोरै छ महिला फोटो पत्रकारहरू 5-6 जना मात्र छ तर यो लङ टर्मसम्म चाहिँ फोटो पत्रकारिता नै गरेर सक्छ भन्ने चाहिँ क्वेसन छ कि कसरी गर्ने हो
मेरो चाहिँ पहिला तपाईँहरू सबैलाई स्यालुट है खास गरी देवकी उमा र अरू पनि धेरै साथीहरू जो बायोलोजिकल्ली वुमेन भनेर चिनिनुपर्छ मलाई लागेको दुई तिनवटा कुराहरू चाहिँ मलाई चाहिँ एकदम खुसी पनि लाग्यो आफू विकास चन्द्र जगदीश दाई र अरू साथीहरूसहित बसेर यहाँहरूको कुरा सुन्दाखेरि सायद नेपालको फोटो पत्रकारिताको चुनौती र अवसर के छ भन्ने विषयमा जुन आजको प्रस्तुति छ त्यो नेपालको होइन कि काठमाडौँको चाहिँ कुरो आयो तपाईँहरूले राखेको कुरा चाहिँ नेपालको चाहिँ आएको होइन होइन यो मेरो पहिलो एउटा टिप्पणी मात्र दोस्रो भनेको सायद विनोद ढुङ्गेलले कुनै बेला नेपालको पत्रकारिताबारे बोल्दाखेरि नेपालको पत्रकारिता खास गरी फोटो पत्रकारितामा बट्टे क्यामेराको महत्त्वपूर्ण भूमिका छ भन्नुभएको थियो बट्टे क्यामेरा भनेको त्यो सानो अटोमेटिक क्यामेरा होइन त्यसलाई म यहाँ अहिले सम्झिन चाहन्छु किनभने अहिले कुरा चाहिँ म दोहोऱ्याउन्न जुन अब मोटरसाइकल हुनुपर्ने क्यामेरा हुनुपर्ने बन्दुक जस्तो लेन्सहरू राख्नुपर्ने त्यो सेक्सी आइडियादेखि बाहिर निस्किने हो भने होइन त्यो ग्ल्यामरबाट बाहिर निस्किने हो भने नेपालको फोटो पत्रकारिता भनेको साँच्चीकै दुरावस्थामा छ होइन चाहे त्यो पारिश्रमिकको रूपले हेरौँ चाहे त्यो विषयवस्तुको प्रस्तुतिको रूपले हेरौँ चाहे त्यो फोटो पत्रकारको प्रस्तुतिको पाटोमा काठमाडौँमा चाहिँ केहीजनाको राम्रो छ होइन जो यो काठमाडौँ भित्र पनि यो हल भित्र पनि हुनुहुन्छ केही हल बाहिर पनि हुनुहुन्छ त नेपालमा चाहिँ ठिक छैन हैन यसलाई चाहिँ हामीले स्वीकार्नु पर्छ अब दोस्रो भनेको अहिले काठमाडौँमा जति पनि मिडिया हाउसहरू छन् हैन ती मिडिया हाउससँग नीतिगत रूपले फोटो पत्रकारिताको बारे विशिष्ट व्यवस्थाहरू केही पनि छैन न स्वतन्त्र रूपले फोटो पत्रकारिता गर्नेको लागि छ न स्वतन्त्र रूपले अक्षरमा या भिडियोमा पत्रकारिता गर्नेको लागि छ न फोटो पत्रकारिता गर्नेको लागि छ त्यसकारणले दुर्दशा अवस्था छ भन्ने हो मेरो आफ्नो भनाइ चाहिँ अहिले पनि निश्चित तलब तोकिएको बाहेक कुनै पनि राम्रो रिपोर्टिङ गर्नको लागि कुनै पनि मिडिया हाउसले फोटो पत्रकारितालाई लगानी गर्दैन चाहे त्यो कान्तिपुर होस् चाहे त्यो हिमाल खबर पत्रिका होस् चाहे त्यो अन्नपूर्ण होस् या राजधानी या त्यो के भन्छ फेरि गाली खाइएला नागरिक फेरि होइन एउटाले हाम्रो नाम दिएन भन्ला फेरि होइन अनि त्यसपछि अब रह्यो हाम्रो पत्रकारितामा पनि के एउटा व्यवस्था छ भने 33% महिलाको उपस्थिति आरक्षणको रूपले पनि हुनुपर्छ भनेपछि नेपालको कुनै पनि मिडिया हाउसमा 33% महिलाहरू छैनन् त्यसले गर्दाखेरि त्यहाँ अहिले पनि भेदभाव छ होइन अहिले पनि गलत खालको संस्कार छ अब त्यसो भए के गर्ने त भन्ने प्रश्न आउला अब त्यसो भए के गर्ने त भन्ने प्रश्न आउँदाखेरि पहिलो त देवकी र उमा जस्ता व्यक्तिहरू त्यो मिडिया हाउसमा सम्पादक भन्नु पऱ्यो फोटो सम्पादक मैले अस्ति श्रुतिलाई पनि भनेको थिएँ तिमी नारीमा चाहिँ किन फोटो सम्पादक नबने अर्को व्यक्तिलाई किन मौका दिएको भनेर यस्तो कतिपय कुरामा हामी प्रष्ट हुनुपर्छ होइन त्यसपछि दोस्रो भनेको यदि अवसर पनि छ र चुनौती पनि छ भने चाहिँ लगानी गर्नमा तपाईँहरूको भूमिका हुनु पऱ्यो मिडिया हाउसको लगानी गर्नमा अहिले पनि हिमाली क्षेत्रमा गएर या कुनै पनि ठाउँमा गएर हाम्रो काठमाडौँमा भएका फोटो पत्रकारहरूले कति रिपोर्टाज लिएर आएको छ त कसैले पनि ल्याउनु भएको छैन अहिले इन्टरनेसनल असाइनमेन्टको कुरा छोडिदेऊ कसैको प्रोजेक्टको काम छोडिदेऊ तर मिडिया हाउसले पठाएकोमा बरु हामीले केहीले बरु पहिला गरेको थियौँ विकास त्यसको एउटा नमुना हुनुहुन्छ पछि मैले पनि एउटा दुइटा काम गर्ने मौका पाएँ होइन सायद म यति नै भन्छु धन्यवाद श्रोतालाई चाहिँ मेरो सलाम किनभने नेपालमा पहिलोपटक यो फोटोग्राफीको लागि चाहिँ केही फाउन्डेसन एउटा बनाएर सघाउने जुन कुरो गर्नुभयो त्यसमा यो फोटो काठमाडौँको पनि महत्त्वपूर्ण भूमिका रह्यो अघि हामी म र विकास एमएसएमा पनि थोरै कुराकानी गर्दैछौँ यो हाम्रो लागि कसैको खबर हो शुभकामना हामीले एकअर्कालाई कसरी सघाउन सक्छौँ धन्यवाद
I will try to do a quick summary. Usha Didi was talking about how she feels that there are actually many, many challenges within the realm of Nepali photojournalism. Our discussion today, she feels, is actually more centered around Kathmandu, but a larger Nepal still exists and there are many challenges that still exist. Let's see, what else? Key points. She was also saying that for women photojournalists particularly to be able to play a stronger, to be able to sort of make changes, that they will need to begin to either be occupying positions higher in the editorial racket, so working as editors or as publishers themselves. So women like Devaki and Uma, who are in this profession, will probably need to be in those positions to really make changes. She also expressed happiness to hear about the foundation today that Sridhar Lal Manandarju and family are interested to set up. These opportunities are new for Nepali photojournalism. I think we are close to wrapping up. Okay, we're going to take one last question and then wrap up. Thank you.
Tini jana lai mero prashna. Photojournalism ko career opportunities, challenges, gender disparity, sabai ko kura bhayo haina. As a whole, reporting kai kura gardaheri. Eventually, the reporting nai garne ho. इभेन्ट भएन भने के गर्ने इभेन्ट बेस्ड बाहेकको रिपोर्टिङ कहिलेदेखि हुन्छ एकदमै रेयर छ होइन त्यो न्युज रुममा किन नभइरहेछ जस्तै लास्ट इयरै एउटा भनौँ न मधेस आन्दोलन हुँदाखेरि फुटे देख्न पाइएन यो सेन्सरसिप गरे हो कि नखटाइएको हो कि यस्तोमा तपाईँहरूले न्युज रुममा चाहिँ हामीहरू यस्तोमा जानुपर्छ अनि त्यस्तो मिटिङ हुन्छ कि हुँदैन कसले डिसाइड गर्छ यस्तो कुराहरू
जहाँसम्म लाग्छ यसमा दुईवटा फ्याक्टर छ जस्तो लाग्छ मलाई, किनभने नेपालको मिडियामा एकदमै नचाहिँदो पोलिटिकल न्युजलाई एकदमै प्रिफरेन्स दिने, किनभने धेरै राइटिङ जर्नलिस्टहरू पोलिटिकल ब्याकग्राउन्डबाट हुनुहुन्छ, कार्यकर्ताकै रूपमा उहाँहरू पत्रकार हुनुहुन्छ, एउटा त्यो कारणले गर्दाखेरि जुन न्युज इभेन्ट नभएको टाइममा हामीले अब अरू के कस्तो सर्ट अफ न्युज इभेन्ट अथवा न्युज कभर गर्ने भनेर भन्नुभयो नि, त्यो सन्दर्भमा चाहिँ न्युज इभेन्ट धेरै प्लेसिङ हुने नेपालको पत्रिकामा, त्यसले चाहिँ धेरै पाउने प्रिफरेन्स पाउने प्लेसिङ पाउने त्यो भएको भएर पनि, अनि हामीले किनभने अर्को कुरा एउटा हामीलाई फोटो स्टोरीहरूको लागि ब्रोडसिटमा अथवा म्यागजिनमै भने न्युज म्यागजिनमा ठाउँ नै छैन, ठाउँ नै दिनै सक्दैन, त्यो भएर हामीले त्यस्तो किसिमको हाम्रो स्टोरीहरू पब्लिस गर्नको लागि हामी इन्करेजमेन्ट छैन हामीलाई, त्यो सिङ्गल फोटोग्राफहरू मात्रै प्रायः र त्यो पनि रिलेटेड टु पोलिटिक्स ओन्ली, त्यो धेरै नै त्यसले प्लेसिङ पाउने भएको भएर हामीले तपाईँले भने जस्तै इभेन्ट नहुँदा अरू किसिमको डेभलपमेन्टको न्युजहरू सोसाइटीको अरू किसिमको फोटो स्टोरीहरू अथवा फोटो एसीहरू त्यस्तोको लागि चाहिँ पब्लिकेसन हाउसले त्यो हामीले चाहिँ प्लेसमेन्टको लागि स्पेस नै नदिने भएको भएर द्याट इज एक्चुली प्रब्लम।
अब मेरो कुरा गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ अब मलाई चाहिँ अब सो मेनी फोटोग्राफ्स द्याट वी टेक एन्ड इट गेट्स किल्ड द नेक्स्ट मर्निङ यु सी देयर इज नन अफ योर फोटोग्राफ्स because of the spacing, the ads, you know, and but luckily in our newspaper when there are like political events, but if you have a better photo, like, you know, something that can make a person change in the morning, like wow, then yes, most of the times the political photo gets killed and our photos get published on the front page, but other than that it's basically mostly political scenarios that gets published. So, and yes, like Dhruba Dai said, the graphic designers and the desk people, like sometimes they have no idea and they just like make your photo a panoramic photo, like they just chop the top part, the left part, and you know, and like I know, like I'm the one to take the photo, and when I see that photo in the morning I'm like, ew, that's so ugly, you know, like because of the cropping problems and all and due to the space, and those are the kind of problems we face.
अब जस्तो फोटो पत्रकारितामा अथवा होल रिपोर्टिङको पार्टमा चाहिँ कहिलेकाहीँ के भयो भने हाम्रो जति पत्रकार र फोटो पत्रकार भयो नि धेरै जस्तो सजिलोको लागि राजधानीमा मात्र केन्द्रित भए, त्यसले गर्दाखेरि मैले विकली पेपरमा काम गर्दाखेरि जस्तो फोटो आज एउटा फोटो खिच्यो भोलि शुक्रबार चाहिँ विकली पेपरमा छापिन्छ भने त्यो किल भइसकेको हुन्छ कि, त्यही भएर जहिले पनि क्रिएसनको पार्ट चाहिँ हुनैपर्छ जस्तो लाग्छ हाम्रो फोटो पत्रकारितामा। त्यो क्रिएसन पार्ट कस्तो भने सामान्य एउटा आँखाले देख्छ भने पनि त्योभित्र पनि के छ अथवा न्युज अथवा त्यसमा चाहिँ आर्टिस्टिक के हुन्छ त्यो फरक ल्याउनु पर्छ। अनि मेरो चाहिँ स्पेसली पार्ट के भयो भने जुनसुकै मिडिया हाउसमा पनि मैले काम गर्दाखेरि होल राइटिङ अथवा फोटो फिचरमा पनि म नेपालको अलमोस्ट डिस्ट्रिक्टहरूमा गइसकेको कारणले फोटो फिचर त्यसमा पनि स्पेसली मैले पोलिटिकल भन्दा पनि सोसल इस्युलाई चाहिँ बढी प्रायोरिटी दिएँ र त्यहाँको टुरिज्म सेक्टर जस्तो राम्रो हिमाल छ पहाड छ अथवा जे देखिन्छ त्यसलाई चाहिँ एउटा न्युजको हिसाबले ल्याएर चाहिँ फरक खालले भएको हुनाले कहिलेकाहीँ न्युज नभए पनि त्यसले चाहिँ स्पेस पाएको मेरो अनुभव छ। त्यही भएर चाहिँ हामीमा एउटा क्रिएसन पार्ट पनि हुनुपर्छ।
And the desk people, you know, and all these other things, they think that our job is so easy. They think it's so easy that you just go there and take a photo, but they don't know the reality behind the struggle that we face, you know, like to reach there on time, to deal with the people, to tackle the situation. And like there are so many like reporters and the desk people, and they still don't understand. And I think we need to have a session and show them that what the real struggle is, you know.
जस्तो अब यसमा एउटा मिडिया हाउसले जहिले पनि रिपोर्टर र फोटो पत्रकारसँग माग्छ मात्र के आफूले के दिन्छ त्यो कहिले हेर्दैन। जब उसले इन्भेस्ट गर्छ तब पो राम्रो चिज आउँछ नि। जस्तो मधेस आन्दोलनको कुरा गर्नुभयो, मधेस आन्दोलनमा किन गएनन्, जान चाहन्छौँ गयौँ पनि तर त्यसमाको रिस्क कसले बेयर गर्ने, हाम्रो क्यामेरा हाम्रो लाइफ। अहिले नेपालमा कस्तो भइरहेछ भने जुनसुकै पत्रकारिता पोलिटिकल पार्टीको पुच्छड भइरहेछ के। तपाईँ कुनै पोलिटिकल पार्टीमा चाहिँ एफिलिएटेड हुनुहुन्छ भने तपाई सेफ हुनुहुन्छ यदि छैन भने छैन यो मेरो लाइफमा चाहिँ म यस्तो इभेन्टहरू धेरै रिस्कहरू बेयर गरिसकेको कारणले पनि म भनिरहेको छु कि जस्तो कहीँ आन्दोलन हुन्छ म गएको छु मेरो स्कुटर तोड्यो मेरो क्यामेरा फुट्थ्यो होला म बचेँ मेरो आइडी कार्ड च्यात्यो तर मैले चाहिँ मेरो प्रोफेसनलमा म जहिले पनि इमान्दार भएँ कि सो 30 दलको जो आन्दोलन भइरहेको थियो बबर महलमा त्यो बेला चाहिँ माओवादीको एकजना हुनुहुन्थ्यो उहाँले चाहिँ आयो फोटो पत्र बडा त चाहिँ केटी भएर बडा स्कुटरमा घुम्छेस् भनेर उसले आइडी कार्ड पनि च्यात्यो मेरो होइन तर मैले हेलमेट लगाएको थिएँ उसले मेरो फेस चिन्न सकेन पछि त्यत्रो 2-3 हजारजनाको बिचमा मैले मेरो फोटो क्यामेरा खिचेर उसको फोटो पब्लिस गरेँ सायद त्यो च्यालेन्ज पनि हो कि पोलिटिकल इस्युहरूमा त्यहाँ गइसकेपछि त्यो इस्यु जब मिडियामा पब्लिस भयो नि त्यसपछि एउटा तहल्का मच्यो उसले त कहाँ छेस् म मार्छु भनेर धम्की दिन थाल्यो हिमालमा पहिला पनि माओवादीको अट्याक भइसकेको थियो यो कारणले गर्दाखेरि यो इस्युलाई धेरै उल्झाउनु पनि थिएन उसले मलाई रेगुलर फोन गर्न थाल्यो कहाँ बस्छस् के गर्छस् बिआइसिसीमा त्यत्रो पोलिटिकल इस्युको हङ्गामा मचिरहेछ ढुङ्गा मुढा पनि भइरहेछ सम्पादकलाई भनिसकेपछि त्यो मान्छेको जब मैले चाहिँ रिसर्च गर्दै गएँ नि त्यो मान्छे नुवाकोटमा 6 महिना जेल बसिसकेको प्रचण्ड जब प्रधानमन्त्री हुनुहुन्थ्यो त्यो 6 महिना उसलाई जस उसले मान्छे मारेको आरोपमा र किडन्यापिङ गरेको केसमा थियो तर उसलाई निकालिएको थियो त्यस्ता त्यस्ता व्यक्तिहरू हुन्छन् पोलिटिकल इस्युमा जब उसले मार्छु भनेर एउटा पत्रकारलाई भन्छ म कुनै पोलिटिकल पार्टीमा छैन प्रेस चौतारी प्रेस युनियन यस्तो भन्छ यदि म त्यस्तोमा भएको भए प्रेस लिजहरू निस्किन्थ्यो मलाई यही कसले गर्यो के गर्यो भने के एक्सन हुन्थ्यो होला तर भएन किनभने तर मसँग प्रुफ थियो म आफ्नो उसमा बलियो थिएँ त्यही भएर त्यो बाहिर आएर पनि म उसँग प्रुफले डिफेन्स गर्न सकेँ हाम्रो मिडिया हाउस डिफेन्स गर्न सक्यो बच्यौँ तर त्यस्तै मधेस मिडिया उसमा पनि हो कि तपाईँ कुनै फोटो ल्याउनुहुन्छ भने त्यसको लागि चाहिँ कहिलेकाहीँ अब कुनै मिडिया हाउसले चाहिँ यो फोटो नछाप्ने अथवा यो आन्दोलनलाई मिडिया हाउसको चाहिँ एउटा कन्फ्लिक्टलाई म्यानेजमेन्ट गर्ने पनि हो कि सधैँ उचाल्ने काम गर्दाखेरि त्यो पनि गाह्रो हुन्छ त्यो ठाउँमा गएर चाहिँ उसको सेफ कसले हेरिदिने उसको क्यामेरा कसले दिने उसको ज्यानलाई कसले हेरिदिन्छ भोलि मारे त मारे त्यहीँनिर हात खुट्टा भाँचे त भाँचे भोलि न मिडिया हाउसले हेर्छ न कुनै युनियनले हेर्छ क्या त्यही भएर मिडिया हाउसले यदि उसमा इन्भेस्ट गर्छ भने त्यसको आउटपुट पनि राम्रो निस्किन्छ जस्तो लाग्छ रिस्क लिएर पनि त्यसको के हो हुने त्यसलाई त्यो नेपालको मात्र होइन यो सबै ठाउँमा यो क्वेसन छ
So the question was a little bit, Arpan was asking when photojournalists will begin to sort of go beyond just event coverage and create news, and particularly looking at, looking back to the example of the Madhes Andolan. Devaki's response was about how sort of little investment there is in the professionals, the photojournalists, by the publishing houses. And the publishing houses are most often just asking for content, asking from the photojournalists. She was recounting some incidents that took place that she herself experienced when she has had to face many political threats. In these situations, the publishing house does not take any guarantees. If Devaki loses a limb or loses her equipment or worst case scenario is killed, nobody takes responsibility for that. So these risks are entirely on her and on the individual themselves. And so there are we were talking earlier about the idea of insurance. There is very little that happens in terms of equipment, but also life insurance. And so these problems do exist. And so in response to why events like the Madhes Andolan are not covered, Dhruvadai was also saying that unless it is a political event, that there is very little assignments that are handed out to photojournalists. So I think hopefully this gives you somewhat of a picture of sort of where things are now. For us here at home, it's really important to continue to have, I think, these conversations. We have one very quick, is it a question or a thought? But we literally have to wrap up now in 1 minute, so very quickly.
Hi, I've had a good fortune of working as a graphic designer in a news environment, in a newsroom, and also have a good opportunity to work as an advertiser. You know, like right now it feels like I'm the guy who's cutting all the pictures and like taking all advertising space.
You are.
Yeah. One good suggestion, you know, you got to talk to the designer. There's often, you know, it's going to sort out the issue and it's just going to make the job easier for both of us. You know, just talk to your designer. Not all newsrooms have like equally qualified, you know, equally like schooled designers. So sometimes it's going to be difficult, but you talk to the designers, you know, you talk like as an advertiser, I wouldn't know. But as a designer, you know, if you talk to the designer, then oftentimes, you know, they'll understand what you're trying to communicate to the picture, and like the ethics, the, you know, whole visual message of the picture will still remain the same.
No, that's a great point, actually, because I did want to end with this information that as an effort to start these conversations, we have a workshop this time that, oh, I'm very happy to say that all three of you are going to be in it, right? Mm. Are you? There's a workshop by Patrick Whitty, who's a photo editor, photo director at National Geographic, and we're hoping that designers, I hope, Swarup, you sign up for it too. I think there's still some space. But it's really an effort to try to get designers, desk editors, editors, reporters, text reporters, and photojournalists in the same room to really talk about these programs and problems, challenges, and to get to learn from sort of what larger publications like National Geographic, Patrick has also worked in Time Magazine, the New York Times, etc. So what happens around looking at good practices, but also talking about challenges here. So with that, I think I would like to wrap up. I'd really like to thank each of you for your time, Dhruva Dai, Skanda, Devaki, and all of you for being here.